Republicans are still going crazy over the fact that the Disney Corporation in the state of Florida has said that they are in fact going to fight against and work to repeal the state's anti-LGBTQ legislation, specifically the so-called Don't Say Gay bill. And Marjorie Taylor Greene, as expected, is one of the most outspoken members of Congress about the evils of the Disney Corporation. And recently, during a conversation with, of course, Alex Jones, she had this to say. It's hard to believe that Disney, Walt Disney, the Walt Disney Company, would be the very place that this is happening. This is supposed to be the happiest place on earth, a place where innocence is celebrated, but it seems to be the place where innocence is actually under attack. Walt Disney, they need to pay a serious price for this. Wow. She also went as far, by the way, as to call them child predators. Child predators at Disney is what they are now. What she didn't mention, however, in that interview is that she owns thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars in Disney stock. In fact, going into the year 2021, she owned, according to financial disclosure forms, anywhere between $1,001 and $15,000 worth of Disney stock. Then in August of that same year, she bought another $1,000 to $15,000 worth of their stock. And then in November, she purchased another $1,000 to $15,000 in their stock. Again, unfortunately, all we have are those ranges for the purchases, but she could own up to $45,000 in Disney stock. The same company that she says is, you know, a bunch of child predators, says they need to pay a price, but looks like you're the one literally paying a price to own a share of the company. So, what is this if not a bunch of Republican hypocrisy? Which, of course, is what they always do. And if they were capable of feeling any kind of shame whatsoever, I'm sure she would be feeling it right now. But Greene in the past has defended her stock purchases, saying, quote, I have an independent investment advisor that has full discretionary authority on my accounts. I do not direct any trades. Well, you also haven't told them to dump the stock either, though. I mean, you should literally, at this point, put your money where your mouth is, right? But you don't want to do that because it's only about making a stand in public, right? Not making a stand financially, not, as we say, voting with your dollars. You just want people to think you're mad at Disney, think that you hate that corporation, when in reality, their success is your success. You're profiting off of this same company that you are now telling conservatives is somehow evil. That they're going against children by fighting against this legislation here in Florida, which, let's be honest, they're not even really fighting against it. So what's your problem? The truth is you don't have one. Conservatives in general don't actually have a problem. They have nothing really to talk about here. They're using this as a wedge issue, a culture war issue, to gain votes ahead of the midterms. That's what it is. 100%. As soon as the midterms are over, this stuff drops off, it dies down, Marjorie Taylor Greene continues to profit off of Disney, and her base and her followers and her supporters ignore the fact that they have been conned just like everybody else in the Republican Party has. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.